Ready to get it started. Hey guys. Oh, my screen dropped. My screen drops. Monday morning, I think it's Sunday. Ooh, I'm thinking it's Sunday. I am fasting for 2 days. I am going to be fasting for 2 days. What's up? How y'all doing today? What's going on? It's Monday. It is Memorial Day Monday. And I am fasting today and tomorrow. I ate yesterday. I wasn't supposed to, but I did. I did. But I will not be eating today. Today will be a straight out all liquid day. Oh, and I'm sitting here looking at this plum. It will be here tomorrow and until Wednesday. So I won't be eating until Wednesday. You like my shirt? Yeah, I guess that could be like a thumbnail, right? My thumbnail. Welcome. It is tea time with me. I feel really good. I'm going to do the same as I did the other day, which is my chamomile tea. I'm going to drink it out of this cup today. My other cup, I don't know what I did with it. And I got me some good old agave. Ooh, I really probably shouldn't have the agave because it's considered more food type. Have it? Not have it. Have it? No. No agave. Probably because also it raises your blood, your sugar. It can regulate your sugar in your system. And when you're fasting, I'm not gonna do that with a knife, right? Cause I took my fork. I don't know what I took my fork. Oh, you know what? I got some. Like the flower part of the, see that here? Those are the flowers of the chamomile. Chamomile helps you to de-stress, helps you to really get rid of a lot of the stress that you may be feeling. Chamomile is really, really good. It is. inside my little baggie. And really, I can just fold these bags like this. I like these tea bags. And just crease it off. Put it in my cup. And I'm pretty much good. See? It stays really well. I like this. And I'm not going to have tea leaves all in my cup. Good morning, guys. Good morning. I'm thinking about doing a YouTube live on... Ooh, that's hot. YouTube live on Sundays. And go through a question and answer. What do you think? And I don't need like a whole cup of tea. Just maybe like a half a cup. See. And that will make my tea, once I let it steep, make it that much more potent. Because I won't use a whole lot of water to my tea. Drinking water all day today. Chamomile tea is going to help me with my anxiety that I may face today. I may not face any anxiety at all. Sometimes I do deal with anxiety. Not like the crazy anxiety. It's like, oh my gosh, I'm just hyper and all over the place. But I do get a bit of the anxiety where I'm just maybe I don't know how to call it. Unsure, indecisive, that type of anxiety. I don't like feeling that, so. All right, let's get started. Hey, what's up, guys? This is part two of my day, and I am just chilling, sitting in this big, I guess, soccer field. It's just a big soccer field. It's really, really big. I like to come up here and just chill out, you know, sit up here and think. I really didn't have much to say today, but I was reading a book that I found that was very interesting. The book is called The Beauty Detox Power. The Beauty Detox Power. And I had the book for a couple of years. I've never opened it. I don't know where I got the book from. Knowing me, I could have got it from the dollar. I could have gotten it from the dollar store. Or maybe I could have bought the book. And if I bought the book, I only bought it because it says New York Times bestseller, right? And so far, every time I read a New York Times bestseller, it's always a really, really good book. I've never been disappointed by a New York Times bestseller. And the part that I'm reading today is about food cravings and understanding the triggers of the food cravings. One of the most important parts that I want to tell you guys about that I thought was so very interesting, if I can find it quickly, is that, let me see, it was about chocolate. Was it about chocolate? Ooh, if I can find it, I don't want to, okay, I'm on page 100, because I don't want to lose it. But it's really good. I underlined it. So I would be able to find it again. Okay. So this particular piece, she talks about spicy foods. And with the spicy foods, and I thought about this like on my own, but then when I read it, it kind of confirmed it for me. You know, sometimes when you think of something, but you're like, that's kind of weird, or that's just me in my own head, or
whatever make believe, or maybe that's not really true because I've never heard it before. No one has ever said it. No one from the medical field or professional field has ever mentioned what it is that I'm thinking in my head. And so sometimes the very same thing that we're thinking in our head is the very same thing that someone else is thinking. The difference is that they probably wrote it down and now they're selling it to you. Not a bad idea. It's okay. Everybody, it's confirmation. I just look at it as confirmation for me. So, this sun is really hot out here and it's beaming in my face. So, we talked about spicy foods and how sometimes we can get into this thing where we're just taking in or eating, ingesting a lot of spicy hot foods, and we'll eat so much spicy foods to the point where it's like there's not enough spice. It can never be hot enough for you. I've always wondered, why is it that a person can take in so much spicy food and never, it is like it's not spicy enough for them? They could do from anywhere from the hottest pepper to ghost pepper to whatever it is. I think the ghost pepper might be the hottest pepper, but they will take it in and they will be like so satisfied with it, or even not satisfied because it's still not hot enough, right? So I've always wondered, could there be an underlining problem for the reason why you can eat spicy foods and it still not be spicy enough for you, even though it can be the hottest spice or pepper on planet Earth, and it's still not hot enough for you? What is the underlining to that? I've always thought that there could be something else going on in your life. Not necessarily anything negative. It could be the fact that, you know, life just isn't, it's not going anywhere. It's boring, it's mundane, it's regular, it's basic, it's nothing's going on. I know I mention the term all the time, oh, getting a little spicy. You know, uh-oh, you gotten spicy now. You know, oh, you putting a little bit of spice in your life. So I know I've mentioned that term on a regular when I'm referring to different things. So when I was sitting here and I'm reading her book, and that's the one thing that it says, I'm gonna read it to y'all exactly how she has it. It says, if you are constantly craving spicy foods, it may be a sign that your life has become mundane or too routine, or that you feel you are not authentically expressing yourself in some aspect of your life. And this is just food. So I'm just on food today, guys. We do this in other things in our life. People do it with tattoos. They do it with body piercings. They do it with strenuous workout activity. They may go out and get a job that they know they don't know how to do. They'll do things that are challenging for them. Sometimes that can be a benefit. And sometimes when all you are doing, or sometimes even when your life is filled of a whole lot of stuff and you're busy and you're all over the place, then you find yourself doing the opposite. You go into maybe a lot of meditation, you go into a lot of quiet places, you go into places where there's nobody around. Like for me, I'm so used to being busy and somebody calling on me and wanting this and wanting that, and I'm always having to think. What do you want? What are we going to do? What are we going to do? What are you going to do? What is he going to do? What is she going to do? What are y'all going to do? All the time. I'm always going through that all the time. So I will find myself isolating myself. I will isolate. I will go into quiet places. I'll go to a place where I don't even have to see a single person at all and just be in a quiet space to myself, give myself time to think, give myself time to read a book. All those good things I would do. And so with this right here, her talking about the food, because sometimes we could be in a space where it's always quiet, it's always regular, it's always mundane, everything is, it becomes kind of stale. And so now you're looking for something to spice up your life. You go bungee jumping, you go skydiving. We do these big elaborate things to bring spice to our life, to bring some type of mix in there. So I just want to say that, not to say that it's a bad thing, that if you like spicy food and you like it hot, hot, caliente, it's not bad. But think about the underlining sources that can be going on with you for the reason why you're looking for that. That spice that you have in your life is not satisfying you enough. What is it? Where is it in your life that you can become complacent, bored, mundane, stale, having a standstill, routined, regular? Where is it in your life that you have become this way? And as soon as you find that thing, look for, do something different. You can still be in the same, like you can still be in the same space, but mix it up a little bit. So find out why it is, where it is that you're having these situations at in your life, and then add flavor to that. Because sometimes, no matter how much flavor you may add to your food, because this is a food, when I was reading about food, this is about food. So no matter how much spice or seasonings or flavors you add to your food, it's never going to satisfy what's really going on in your life. So if you've been able to get something from out of this message, it was for you. And if you weren't, it was for me. Either way, the message is always for me. Because I know there's a lot of places in my life where I want spice, and then there's a lot of places in my life where I want it to be kind of regular. So, all right, y'all, peace. Enjoy your day. Once again, this is Memorial Day weekend. Enjoy your time with your family and your friends. And I'll talk to you later.